it's not just the learner on the autism spectrum that's on a VI schedule. Like, literally, people think that shit. Like, they think ABA is totally just for that. But every minute of every day, you're under some influence of a contingency. I think it's really important for you to make every goal visual. This is just my personal, but there is definitely behavioral science behind the idea that the graphic feedback on your performance is motivating. But I like to make it so friggin' visual that it's hanging in my bedroom, weird shit like that. Like, it's not very romantic. But like, I like to make it so, yeah, like that's hot. You know, like I like to have it so visual that I like to say, if you can view it, you can do it. That's my motto. If you can view it, you can do it. There's one thing you might hit on this. I don't know if I'm stealing your thunder.
That's okay.
But if you stretch someone too thin, like the ratio strain, like if they go to the bathroom like 50 times and don't get anything, mm-hmm. that ratio strain that could occur. There's one thing that you need to do with the reinforcement. This would be a BACB question on the test. If you're gonna thin that schedule, there's something you have to do with the reinforcement. Does anybody know what it is? Say it.
Increase the magnitude.
It's sort of like, you know, what I say, that I always suggest that if you're gonna have increased response effort, I just think you deserve something more.
The next one's the variable interval schedule. And for this, it is the same as, similar to the fixed, however, the time is varying. So for this, the key feature is that it totally is almost random when the reinforcement or the interval is lasting. It produces a constant stable rate, however, not as increasing quick rates as our previous schedules. This one, definitely, I feel like you see the most when you're working with like on-task engagements, on and so forth. In the classroom, at least, I've seen. Do you guys use any variable interval schedules?
I can give you a perfect example of one that you do day-to-day that you don't even realize. You're on a VI schedule, a variable interval schedule. If you're waiting for the mail, like you're waiting for a check in the mail, that mailman might come at 11:05 or 10:50 or 11:10 or exactly at 11 or 10:49. Like, you know around when they're coming. So if the average is 11 that the mailman comes, you go out to the mailbox at like 10:50, 10:59, 11:05, and you're going to the mailbox a lot. Like if you don't see it, you're just checking. That's a VI schedule. It produces high, steady rates of responding. Do you ever think of it that way? So it's not just the learner on the autism spectrum that's on a VI schedule. Like, literally, people think that shit. Like, they think ABA is totally just for that. But every minute of every day, you're under some influence of a contingency. And
I like to bring this up to my husband, and he just freaks out. Mm-hmm. Like, just stop! Yeah. Not everything! And yeah. I'm like, it is, though.
It is. That's a good gem. So sometimes there's ritualistic behavior that is so reinforcing, you have to use that as part of your contingency. So there's been plenty of times that I've had kids, or you could use it as a punisher. I'll give you an example. I had a kid that was so aggressive in a residential setting that he would, but he was very ritualistic. So if you had his stuffed animals that were in his room, it sounds kind of mean, but the stuffed animals that were in his room, they were lined up on a shelf in his bedroom, and they had to be in a certain order because of his ritualistic compulsions. You know what I mean? He had to have them in a certain order. It would be upsetting if he didn't. So he was very aggressive also. So what we did is we exhausted, of course, all positive reinforcement strategies. Disclaimer. We reinforced all positive reinforcement strategies, like trying to reinforce this for appropriate behavior. Nothing worked, so we had to use a punisher. We couldn't tolerate him hitting everyone. So our contingency was a punishment contingency, because we have to decrease the behavior. So all we did is that every time he was aggressive, we just started friggin' popping off the stuffed animals, and it would interrupt his aggression. He would not hit you to be like, wait, I gotta fix the stuffed animals. You know what I mean? So his behavior that was ritualistic, it was a compulsion, he had to engage in it enough to the point where it would interrupt any kind of aggression, and it was a punisher. The aggression went down because we used the ritualistic behavior to work for us. Does that make sense? So you got to get creative with stuff. That's, and then the only question would be, how do you generalize that to the real world? Like, you're not going to be in a bedroom with stuffed animals all day, right? So what we had to do is find something that was mobile that he didn't like, that if you threw it on the ground, he felt compelled to pick it up. So we could be in a community, and if he had an aggressive behavior, we throw these things on the ground. He'd go from like, oh shit, I better pick it up.
Was it used as like a redirection too? Like he would stop the aggression after he picked it up too?
Yeah, because it was like disturbing to him, and it would just interrupt it. It would interrupt it and punish it, and then he wouldn't go back to the aggression. All you're doing is decreasing something dangerous. So a punisher is simply something that decreases a behavior, and it's such a dirty word. Like, why is everyone so freaked out about it? The issue is that we have to be ethically responsible to first try a positive reinforcer. And if that doesn't work, you need something to decrease the behavior, which is a punisher.